As you can see, I have my festive top on, ready for our December all-in edition of PW. Normally we'd be meeting with our warmed mince pies and our sticky sausages, with a night full of chat and crack, but not so this year. But let us remember what Christmas is all about, that Jesus is a present from God to us. So remember the PW theme, as tonight is side by side, enjoy at Christmas.
The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favoured. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favour with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end.
So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Well, ladies, for those of you who have been with us on a PW Christmas evening, you will know every now and then we throw in a little craft. And the last one we did were those lovely little wooden hearts with the napkin transfer on it, and we had a good old giggle doing those. Maybe a wee bit of stress whenever things were stuck down and they didn't come off or they weren't meant to be there. But they're a lovely little thing to have, just to remind us of that night and just of times together. But tonight we have another little creative thing that you can do. You don't need to be creative in any way. This is simply a little rectangle of felt, and I've nipped it in the middle. It actually looks like a little dicky bow. Nipped it in the middle, put a little bit of ribbon on it. Or in this one, I have cut the rectangle into strips and just pulled them out with a little bit of a different cord to hang it up. Or this real wee cute one, just like that. And the idea of these is that you hang them on a door, or you hang them on your handbag or your Christmas tree. And so people will say to you, "What is that you have hanging there?" Or maybe you're in work somewhere and you can hang one of them up so that your work colleagues can ask you. And so they're little prompts and little avenues so that when people ask you what they are, it gives you an opportunity to talk about Jesus, maybe even to tell the little lesson that we're going to think about now. And so we've been thinking about side by side in joy. And we're going to look at how fear turned to joy with the shepherds in the Nativity, a lesson in the Bible. And so the shepherds were in the fields outside Bethlehem, we're told, and an angel was sent to them to tell them about the birth of Jesus. Now, if you can imagine the conversation in heaven when God is commissioning the first angel to go and to tell the shepherds about Jesus' arrival. Now, very often we saw Jesus talking and relating to ordinary people, and so the same seems to be happening here. The angel comes to ordinary men doing an ordinary job out in the fields. But it is ironic that they come to shepherds, because what is Jesus known as? As he matures, he is known as the Good Shepherd. But the angel comes to the shepherds, and of course they are fearful at the start that they see an angel. But the angel puts them at ease and tells them not to be afraid, because the angel brings them good tidings of great joy that will be to all the people. And so they wonder what this joy is going to be. And so the angel tells them that there will be a sign, and he tells them this sign will be a babe will be lying in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. Now, these shepherds are doing an ordinary job, but there is a theory which I'm going to throw out there. It's not my theory, it's already pre-existed, and you can do a little bit of homework on it yourself. But this theory is that these shepherds had a special job, and their special job was to look after the flock of sheep. And whenever the ewes, or the yows, depending what part of the country you're from, were about to give birth, they would take them away, and when the lamb was born, they would wrap the lamb in swaddling cloths and lie them in a manger. And their job was then, when the lambs calmed down, because they didn't want them thrashing about in case they hurt themselves, because a sacrificial lamb for the temple had to be perfect, had to have no blemishes. And so when they wrapped them in the lamb, laid it in the manger, and then when the lamb maybe came to peace, it's quieter, they would unwrap the cloths and then inspected the lamb just to make sure that it was perfect to be used as a sacrificial lamb. And so this was their job. And so very often we saw Jesus relating to people when he was trying to teach them. He taught them about, he used farming means, he used about the sower and the reaper, he used shepherding themes in his stories. And he was able to relate to the jobs of the people. And so the angel seems to be doing likewise here, just relating to the shepherds and what they can identify with. And you can almost hear the cogs going in their brain, can't you, that they're saying, well, actually, we understand this because that is our job. We sort these lambs out and we get them ready for a sacrificial offering to God. And you know, when the angel told the shepherds that Jesus was born and that there would be a sign, this was sent by a backup of a host of an army of angels coming and telling them of the great joy that was happening in Bethlehem. And so when those angels went back up into heaven, the shepherds didn't waste any time, because we're told that they hurried with haste to Bethlehem. Now, if we pause for a minute, the angel didn't tell the shepherds how to get to Mary, Joseph and Jesus. He didn't say to follow a star. He didn't give them a name of a road or of a field. They just were going to go to Bethlehem. And they said, let's go and see this thing that God has told us about. So they recognized that the angels were from God and that it was God speaking to them, because beforehand they just had the prophets. But now God was speaking to them. And sometimes when we get really excited, we don't know what to say about a special situation or an experience. And we say it was a wonderful thing that happened. It was amazing. And so the shepherds are saying, let's go and see this amazing thing that has happened. Now, if follow the same line of them being shepherds that had a special job, the Leviticus shepherds preparing the sheep, they would have known exactly where to go to. Because Micah, in the Old Testament, prophesies that Jesus, God's son, will be born in Bethlehem. And he refers to a place called the watchtower of the flock, or the watchtower for the flock. And it's called Migdal Eder. And it's a place where the shepherds, who were looking after these lambs for the temple, would have taken the ewes when they were about to give birth. And it was kind of like a structure built with stone. There was the first level, which is very clean. And then the second level, where maybe the shepherds looked out over their flocks. And so this was a place that they took the lambs and wrapped them in swaddling cloths. And there's a theory that the swaddling cloths were pieces pulled off the priests of the temple of their cloaks, and they were left there to be able to wrap the lambs up in. So bearing in mind that the shepherds are thinking, well, it's a sacrificial lamb in a manger, in swaddling cloths, we know where this is. So they went straight to that tower, to that watchtower. Now, again, and part of the theory is that there maybe was a cave linked with this just into the hill, and that's maybe where Mary and Joseph were, and that's where Mary birthed Jesus, and she was able to use some of the swaddling cloths. Some commentators say, no, that the shepherds just went into Bethlehem and searched out Jesus. Now, for that, I'm just not too sure, because let's remember, this was the height of the census, that people were coming to Bethlehem to be counted. And remember, Joseph and Mary couldn't find a room. So can you imagine the shepherds going around houses and homes and inns, asking if there was a baby in there? By the time they'd go and ask, by the time they'd bring the baby out, no, it's not wrapped in swaddling cloths, it's not the baby, on to the next house. It kind of would have taken a lot of time. Now, it's very plausible that the Holy Spirit could have guided the shepherds to Mary, Joseph and Jesus. But if we link that Old Testament section to that New Testament section, it would make sense that they knew exactly where to go to. And so they went there and they marvelled at what they saw. And they were able to tell Mary about their experience in the field. And maybe Mary and Joseph talked to them about what had happened to them, especially when the angel came to Mary. And you know, we're told that Mary pondered these things in her heart. You know, she'd just given birth to her child, given birth to the Son of God. And here she's hearing that angels came and proclaimed his birth. How wonderful that is. And maybe she remembered all the promises that God had given to her, and that he would be with her, and that she was doing a very important job with Jesus Christ. And so in this current climate, with COVID, with other anxieties, with other worries, it can be a fearful time, and this is the reason why we have to do an online PW, and it can cause fear in our lives. And yet, if we take a leaf out of Mary's book and think about the times when God has been faithful with his people throughout the generation, throughout the Old Testament and New Testament, and think of the promises and those memory verses that you learnt as a child, and all of the things that God said that he would do for his children. And maybe even as the shepherds, they had fear at the start, but then it turned to joy when they realised that Jesus Christ, God incarnate, came to earth to be that last sacrificial lamb for mankind. Because we couldn't get to heaven, and God provided a means for us to be forgiven for our sins, not through any work of our own or through any efforts, but by believing in Jesus Christ and asking him to forgive us for our sins, and then living a life that is worthy of it. Have you done that? Have you asked Jesus to be your saviour? Do you recognise that Jesus took your punishment for your sins so that you could be in heaven with God one day? And maybe if you have, maybe you can use one of these little strips or make something up yourself so that it gives you a little prompt, because it's really anxious at times too, and we maybe get butterflies in our tummy whenever we talk about Jesus to somebody else, whether it be a stranger or a family member. And this can be a wee simple way of getting you to start that and maybe tell a lesson that we've been thinking about tonight. So side by side in joy. May Jesus be your joy this Christmas. And whatever hardship you may be going through, that you would ask God to give you the strength to get through it and to know that he is faithful with his children. Side by side in joy.
Let us pray. Lord, as we come into the Christmas season, we thank you for sending your Son to be born as a baby and become our Saviour. Lord, we thank you that through him we can have true peace and joy in our hearts. Father, we know that although Christmas is usually a time for celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ and spending time with family and loved ones, this year it is going to be a very different experience for us all. Lord, we pray for our nation at this time, that people will look out for others and know that even the smallest thing can make a big difference. Father, we pray for kindness towards the people who are trying to keep us safe. And Lord, we pray that we will be able to take on board the safety measures that are being offered to us. Father, we thank you for our NHS and all our key workers that you have provided for us. Lord, they really have stepped up at this very difficult time to make sure we have all we need to live. And Lord, we just pray at this time the government will look to you and listen to your guidance when it comes to the important decisions they have to make for our country. These things we pray in your name. Amen.
Tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. While shepherds kept their watching over silent flocks by night, behold, throughout the heavens there shone a holy light.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing.
Way up in the sky, little lamb, do you see what I see? A star, dancing in the night, with a tail as big as a kite.
It came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their harps of
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know?
The first Noel, the angel did say, was to serve.